Hello friends, in this video we are going to talk about the basics of one of the television standard, that is NTSC. We are also going to cover why NTSC comes into the picture, what are the advantages, disadvantages of the NTSC. So let's begin with the topic. We know that the two main power supply frequencies are used in the world, and they are 50 Hz and 60 Hz. As the power supply frequency is divided into two factors, definitely the color television standard also get divided into two factors, that is the one which uses a frequency of 60 Hz and other which uses a frequency of 50 Hz. The standard which uses a frequency of 60 Hz uses 30 frames per second, whereas the other which uses a frequency of 50 Hz uses 25 frames per second. So depending upon which frequency is used, different standards are used for the color television. The three main standards are NTSC, PAL and SC-CAM. Now in this topic, we are basically going to discuss about a standard that is nothing but NTSC, which was developed by the America, that is United States. So let's start. Now, in case of NTSC, the full form of NTSC is National Television Standard Companies. So, in NTSC, the chrominance signal is basically denoted, or it is an alternating current signal which is having a precise and accurate value of frequency. The value of frequency is given as 3.579545 plus minus 0.000010 megahertz. This value is defined very precisely and accurately. The reason behind this is because of this precise value, it is possible to accurately recover the signal at the receiver. And for that purpose, that means for accurate recovery of the signal, the value of frequency is precisely defined. So here also it is mentioned that the precise permitting accurate recovery of the receiver even in the presence of noise and interference. So even if the noise is present in the signal or even in the presence of interference, it is possible to accurately recover the signal which is received by the receiver because of the fixed and accurate value of the frequency. Now, the NTSC is the video system or a standard, that is the television standard, used in North America and most of the South America. Now in case of NTSC, as it uses a frequency of 60 Hz, it passes 30 frames per second. So in NTSC, 30 frames are transmitted each second, and each frame consists of 525 individual scan lines. Now let's see why NTSC comes into the picture. So in 1950s, the black and white television ill to ground, and the technical standards which was used at that time were not so useful. So at that time, the American Broadcasting Company uses some of the standard or wide range of standard for encoding the signal. But these standards having some conflict with each other. Therefore, a common standard comes into the picture, that is nothing but NTSC. So this is how the NTSC comes into the picture. So until 1953, there was no common standard that can be used for the television system. But after that, a standard comes that is called as NTSC, that is nothing but National Television System Committee. Now, this format was developed with the intention to compatible with most of the TV set in the countries, whether the color or black and white. That means the standard is basically defined, or it is basically provided the compatibility between the color and monochrome system, that is black and white system. The modern television broadcaster switched to a digital, the number of resolution lines and frame rates they are used are the same as established by NTSC format. That indicates even if we use a modern television system which uses a digital methods of encoding and decoding, but they uses the same frame rate and they uses the same number of line which are decided by the NTSC system. The NTSC system provides a proper video signal when it is used in the closed circuit environment or when it is used for the video purpose. But when we use the NTSC system in the broadcasting environment, then at that time it results into the variation of color. So this is the major problem which is provided by the NTSC system. Apart from this problem, the NTSC system provides many advantages. For example, it provides better stability, it provides high signal to noise ratio, then it provides simple circuitry, it provides easy audio mixing. As it provides larger bandwidth, therefore the flicker is get reduced in the picture. Similarly, if you talk about the frame rate, the NTSC system provides higher frame rate. Then in case of NTSC system, the cost of the system is get less as compared to the other standard. So one of the major benefit of the NTSC system is nothing but the low cost. Other benefit of the using NTSC system is the simple construction, high frame rate, easy studio mixing. So these are the various advantages that are provided by the NTSC system. In India, most of the system uses are nothing but the NTSC system, and it's considered as a primary television standard used in most of the country, which uses a frequency of 60 Hz. So this is what about the basics of NTSC system. So I hope you understand this topic. So thank you very much for watching this video. Stay tuned to Ekeeda. Subscribe Ekeeda. Thank you.